Welcome to Gray on Math. We are asked to solve for this problem. A circle is inscribed in a triangle with sides AB, which is equal to 4, BC is equal to 6, and AC is equal to 8. If P and Q are respective points of tangency of A and B and AC with the circle, determine the length of the chord PQ. Okay. So, first thing we have to do is we have to draw here that the perpendicularity between AC and Q, and that is perpendicular, and this is perpendicular also. Okay, we are actually to determine the length of chord PQ. Okay, so next thing that we have to do is we have to label, of course, the center of the circle as O. And we draw a line from point A to the center of the circle. We form two right triangles, ABO and AOQ. These two right triangles are congruent because they share the same hypotenuse. So they have the same length over the hypotenuse and their radius are the same. So that is already two sides. So next is actually this hypotenuse bisects angle A. So these the angles are actually congruent. And if they are congruent, say this is angle is X and this is X, then this angle here is 90 minus x, and this is also 90 minus x. So we have two right triangles which are congruent to each other. And with that, if you have the same angle here, 90 minus x, it is opposite a side which is AP, and this angle is opposite to AQ, and since they are opposite to two the equal angles, then these two lengths are congruent. And also, if we draw a perpendicular line from the center of the circle to BC, then the same is true as with APQ. If we draw a line from the center of the circle to B, we'll be forming a two right triangles. Okay, and if we draw a line here from C to the center of the circle, we will be forming again two right triangles. Label this as PQR. Then we have two triangles. If we focus on OQC, right triangle, and ORC, and there is another two sets of right triangles, which is POB and BOR. Okay, so actually we form three pairs of triangles that are congruent. Okay, so and with that, of course, being congruent, each pair being congruent, they have each side as congruent. So we can label this, if we focus on the pair AOQ and APO, we can say that this would be A and A. And for PO and RBO, two triangles, we can say that this would be B and B. And for the two triangles, COQ and COR, this side is we can say that this is C, then this is C. Then we can form three equations from that. Okay, so now we have made representations on the segments, on the lines of the triangle, then we can simply make equations about that. So for the line AB of the triangle, we can say that A plus B is equal to 4. And knowing the length of line BC, which is equal to 6, and it is implied that B plus C is equal to 6, B plus C. And for the line AC, we have A plus C is equal to 8. And we label these equations as 1, 2, and 3. So now, to solve this system of equations, we have to simply add the three equations. So we have 2a plus 2b plus 2c is equal to 18. Okay. And if we divide that by 2 or multiply it by 1 half, we have a plus b plus c is equal to 9. Since we are only interested on the length of BQ, then we are to find, of course, the length A, letter A. So if we subtract equation 2 from equation 4, and that would be equation 4, A plus B plus C is equal to 9. If we subtract B plus C, equal to negative 6. Then we have this cancels out B and C. Then we have A is equal to 3. Okay, so now we are to use cosine law since we are interested only on the side BQ. Then we can say if we use cosine law, we have, if we focus on the whole triangle, we have BC square equal to AB square plus BC square minus 2 times AB times AC times cosine of A. But BC square is equal to 6 square, AB is equal to 4 square plus AC, which is equal to 8 square minus 2 times 4 times 8 cosine of A. Okay, so cosine of A is equal to 6 square minus 4 square minus 8 square divided by negative 2 times 4 times 8. Okay, so this can be simplified on the numerator as 36 minus 16 minus 64 all over negative 2 times 4 times 8. But this is actually negative 44. So cosine of A is equal to negative 44 all over the negative of 2 times 4 times 8. But we can divide this 4 and this by 4. This becomes 11 over 16. Cosine of A is actually equal to 11 over 16. Okay, so for if we are to find PQ, then we need to focus on the triangle APQ, and again, we use the law of cosines. And for the law of cosines for the line PQ, it is actually equal to A squared plus A squared minus 2 times A times A times cosine of A. Okay, so BQ square is equal to 3 square plus 3 square minus 2 times 3 times 3 times 11 over 16. Okay, so simplifying further, we can cancel this out. Becomes 8. And PQ square is equal to 9 plus 9 minus 9 times 11 over 8. We can factor out 9. And we have 1 plus 1 minus 11 over 8. So PQ square equal to 9 times, this is 8 and this is 8 plus 8 minus 11. So 16 minus 11 actually equal to 5. And over 4 times 2, which is 8, and times 9. Okay, so PQ square is equal to 9 over 9 times 5 times 4 over 2. So PQ is actually equal to the square root of 9 times 5 over 4 times 2. So PQ equal to 3 over 2 times the square root of 5 over 2. But we need to rationalize this, so we need just to multiply it by square root of over the square root of 2. So PQ equal to 3 over 2 times the square root of 10 over 2. And simplifying further, we have PQ is equal to 3 square root of 10 over 4. And that is our answer. Now, thank you for watching until the end of the video. Please like the video if you like our solution, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be updated for more math videos like this. Thank you. Bye.